First and foremost, I'd like to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh by Hashem, Yahweh Shai by Hashem, God with Dash, double honors to the apostles and elders of great millstone who rule well and who has 100% truth. This is for the whole free elect of Israel, which are so-called Negroes, Latino, and Native Americans, also these speckled birds that scatter across the four corners of the earth, that's mingled within other nations to make look like the other heathen nations. If this word resonates with you, then your lineage go back from your father's side to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. You are the true Hebrew Israelites in which the Bible speaks of. First and foremost, the name of Heavenly Father is Yahweh. Yah is He, Hawah. He is this, He is. The name of His only begotten Son, His beloved Son, is Yahweh Shai. Yah is He, Yahweh Shai, the Savior, the Deliverer. And our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shai, is whom we are waiting for to come in these last days, and we are in the last of the last days. Okay? Let me get to the point. Let's go to Habakkuk. This is the book of Habakkuk 2, okay? And one of it reads, I will stand upon my watch and set me upon the tower, and will watch to see what he will say unto me, and what I shall answer when I am reproved, okay? And we as watchmen, the prophets, we set upon our tower as they did back in the ancient days, and as anyone would do if they enlisted in the military or been drafted, you will stand upon your watchtower, okay? And you will be looking for when the enemy comes. And that's what we are looking for and warning you about this, okay? I will stand upon my watch and set me upon the tower, okay? Because you're up high and you're looking down and you can see a distance, okay? And you can tell, you can see when someone is trying to enter the city, okay? And you will warn the people. And you will blow that trumpet. I will watch to see what he will say unto me and what I shall answer when I am reproved. Okay? And the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, in all caps, answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain upon tables that he may run that readeth it. Okay? So be warned of people that are going to run. Okay? And they're going to say, what? That's what's happening. Oh, man, I got to tell everybody else. I got to tell some people. And then it goes on down the line. Okay? It goes down the line. They're going to tell you. The prophets will tell you what's going on, okay? And who's coming, okay? And warn you. Because the prophets come before destruction. If you don't warn nobody, then they're going to be caught without that warning and destroyed, okay? And Heavenly Father Yahweh answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain upon tables that he may run that readeth it, okay? For the vision is yet for an appointment. A point of time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie, though it tarry, away for it, because it will surely come, it will not tarry. And as you see, you know, the Revelation 13:16 is already out here, okay? The kerygma, it's already out here, okay? It just has to be made mandatory, and that's a major prophecy you cannot get wrong, okay? If you get that wrong, it's going to cost lives, and you will be charged for it, according to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, through these holy scriptures, okay? For the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come. It will not tarry, and it's not tarrying, okay? Wisdom and knowledge has increased right now. Daniel 12 and 4, everybody's walking around here with a phone in their pocket, okay? It's a lot of information on this phone. You can instantly look up things. The hard work that's been done by the apostles and elders of the great millstone, okay? They went to the library. They did all the research. Now, all this research has been put, okay, on these devices digitally, and you can easily bring them up. You have to do the work. You have to be like the Church of Berea, okay? But our job is to warn you. Ezekiel 3 and 17. Book of Ezekiel, prophet Ezekiel. Third chapter and 17 verse. Let me get to the points. Son of man, I have made thee a watchman to the house of Israel. Therefore, hear the word at my mouth and give them warning from me. And that's what we are doing. Giving you the warning of things to come that's going to happen, that must happen, that's prophesied to happen. Okay? Prophecy me, this say before. Okay? When I say unto the wicked, thou shalt surely die, and thou givest him not warning, nor speakest to warn the wicked from his wicked way to save his life, the same wicked man shall die in his iniquity. But his blood will I require at thine hand. Okay, so if you don't warn him, okay, and you know the names of the Heavenly Father, his only begotten Son, Yahweh, Yahweh Shai, and you put it in a napkin, you're not warning him, that blood's going to be required at your hand. Okay, that's why you have to continue to do the work. Okay, you know, be diligent with it. Okay, when I say unto the wicked that thou shalt surely die, thou givest him not warning, nor speakest to warn the wicked from his wicked way to save his life, the same wicked man shall die in his iniquity. That's sin upon sin. Okay, but his blood will I require at thine hand. So you're gonna have to answer to the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, because you did not warn the wicked. Okay. Verse 3, Ezekiel 3:19. Yet if thou warn the wicked, and he not turn from his wickedness, nor from his wicked way, he shall die in his iniquity. But thou hast delivered thy soul. And the wicked, you got the wicked and the wicked. Okay, the wicked Esau, Edom, British and Lee banking family, Job 9:24, was given the earth was given over to the hands of the wicked by Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai for a purpose, okay? His son of perdition, he's gonna be destroyed. Okay, but you got the wicked, okay, which is you two-thirds. Got to warn you anyway. And which I hopefully let might be mingled up in there and come back to worship the Heavenly Father Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai. Okay? It may come back to worship. Okay? We're calling the hopeful elect of Israel, but we have to call out. We have to go out on the highways and byways, do these video epistles every day, okay? Because when we're calling out, as I said in the beginning, we are amongst all the nations, okay, over here from the Father's side. It may look like the other heathen nations, so the elect is mingled within all these nations, okay? Yet if thou warn a wicked, and he turn not from his wickedness, nor from his wicked way, he shall die in his iniquity. But thou hast delivered thy soul. So you have a job to do. You can't go back to the world and then come back. You got to keep on your job, okay? As a watchman, okay? You got to keep on your job because the day of darkness is coming, okay? As soon as Revelation 13:16, the Quran will be made mandatory, you got Jacob's trouble, okay? And at the end, those thermonuclear missiles hidden. Babylon the Great, a.k.a. America, is going to be destroyed. Some of the Middle East is going to be destroyed, but be rebuilt back up because that's going to be our headquarters. Lord willing, one of the men. Okay? But we have to warn. We have to do our job. And we have to endure to the end. Okay? Joel, too. Book of Joel. Two and one. Blow ye the trumpet in Zion, and sound an alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Heavenly Father Yahweh coming, for it is nigh at hand. Okay, first, we have to get past, Revelation 13:16, the Karagma, when they make that. You know, that you have to have it, make it mandatory, okay? Well, then that's when things are going to start speeding up, okay? Again, Jacob's trouble. You know, they can't tie you up and make you take it, you know, but it's going to be a choice. They're going to fool you with things. They're going to make you dependent upon them. But if you take it, you're going to be destroyed, Revelation 14:9 verse on down, okay? You take it, you're going to be destroyed by Yahweh Hashem Yahweh, by those thermonuclear missiles. Other things going to be happening to you, okay? So don't take that karam, don't take that mark, that, you know, that MOTB, don't take it, okay? That's a warning. You take it, you're going to be destroyed by Yahweh Hashem Yahweh, with the thermonuclear missiles that are coming, okay? Because that day is going to be a darkness and a gloominess, okay? Joel 2:1, blow you the trumpet, in Zion and sound an alarm in my holy mountain, that all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the heavenly God of Yahweh coming, for it's nigh at hand. And it's close. You see what's going on, okay, around the world. Middle East, okay? You got all that going on, okay? You also got Russia and Ukraine. That's going on. And all these other nations, these BRIC nations, they're coming up against Babylon the Great, a.k.a. America, spiritual Sodom and Egypt, okay? Because they're tired of Esau, you know, Richard Lee Bacon finally putting down their rules, okay? They've been found out, okay? This truth has found them out. And everybody see the people that they are, the wicked that they are. Job 9:24, Malachi 1:4, okay? The Heavenly Father, Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh, Shai, it's exposing them through the prophets, through the apostles, all those great men, so on and down. They're being exposed, okay? Now everybody know who they are and who we are. The truth, okay? That's why the scripture says, who the Son sets free is free indeed. The truth will set you free, okay? The truth. You can't stop the truth. You can't do anything against this truth but for the truth, okay? And that's what's happening. They're being brought down, okay? Through this truth, okay? A day of darkness, of gloominess, a day of clouds and thick darkness. As the morning spread upon the mountains, a great people and strong, they have not been ever the like. Neither shall be any more after, even to the years of many generations. Okay. And this is literally and figuratively. Okay. It's going to be a day of darkness. That darkness, you know, it's going to be, you know, this is speaking of destruction, misery, death, sorrow, okay? That's what they're speaking about. A day of darkness. There's going to be no knowledge of wisdom or understanding at that time of what's happening. No. Because they didn't listen to the warning. They're right here doing the things they always been doing. And when that day of darkness come, it's going to come on them, okay? It's going to come on them. And it's going to hit them unaware because of their pride. Okay, great people and strong, they have not been ever the like. Neither shall be any more like it after it, even to the years of many generations. Okay? Because this has never happened before. Never happened in history. Okay? Not on this kind of level. Okay? It's going to be death, destruction, gloominess. Okay. And it never happened like this before. You can look back on the destruction of Sodom and Gomorrah, okay? But that's nothing compared to what's getting ready to happen. Okay? It's nothing. And also, it was destroyed by fire and brimstone, but this is on a whole different level. Okay, it's going to top everything, okay? The destruction of Babylon the Great, a.k.a. America, spiritual, Sodom and Egypt, okay? It's going to be totally destroyed. It's going to be desolate, okay? It's going to be desolate. Now, I think Albert Einstein said this, okay? The final war, okay, it's going to be, you know, this war is going to be, you know, concerning nuclear missiles, the Third World War. After this, the next war is going to be with sticks, okay? It's going to be fought with sticks because it ain't going to be no more, you know, there ain't going to be nothing left, you know? It's going to be going back to, it's going to be back to the Stone Age. But see, that was just his opinion. What's going to happen is that it ain't going to be no more wars because this kingdom is going to be translated over to our Lord and Savior Yahweh. And then under him, King David, and then 144,000 men of the ruling government of Israel, along with the one-third men, women, and children, okay? The kingdom is going to be Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh's kingdom, okay? You And that's what's going to happen. Isaiah 2. Let's get it. Isaiah 2 and 1. The word of Isaiah, the son of Amos, saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem. And it shall come to pass in the last days that the mountain of the heavenly fathers, Yahweh's house, shall be established in the top of the mountains, and shall be exalted above the hills, and all the nations shall flow into it. The top of the mountains, all these heathen governments, okay? We're going to be ruling over them. We're going to be the heavenly father, Yahweh, by some of Yahweh's house, is going to establish the rulership over all these nations, okay? It's going to take down all these nations and establish the rule, okay? And all nations shall flow into it, okay? And many people shall go and say, come ye and let us go up to the mountain of the heavenly father Yahweh, to the house of the power of Jacob. And he will teach us his ways, and we will walk in his paths. For out of Zion shall go forth the law and the word of the heavenly father Yahweh from Jerusalem. Ain't going to be no more eating that pork. Ain't going to be no more eating rats, crab, none of that. Octopus, you're going to have to follow the way of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh, our laws, statutes, and commandments. So for all of you to say the law's been done away with, how can it be? How can it be when you're going to be following our laws, okay? And many people shall go and say, come ye, and let us go up to the mountain of the heavenly father Yahweh, to the house of the power of Jacob. That's another thing. He's not the power of you heathen, he's the power of Jacob. Okay? The seed of Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. That's who he's the power of. Our heavenly father Yahweh, by Hashem Yahweh, sir. Not you heathen, nation. Isaiah 2 and 4. And he shall judge among the nations, shall rebuke many people. And they shall beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. Nations shall not lift up sword against nations. Neither shall they learn war anymore. That's how you know that those are imposters over there in our land right now. They're fighting each other. They're killing each other over there. It's not supposed to be. Okay? This place getting ready to get taken down with all these heathen nations. Esau, Edom is going to be extinguished after he serves us for 1,000 years. He's going to be wiped out, burnt out. Won't be no more. He can't rule with us. Ain't no such thing as that. That won't happen. That's prophesied. That's prophecy. That's prophecy. Joel 2. Third verse. The fire devoured before them, and behind them a flame burning. The land is as the garden of Eden before them, and behind them a desolate wilderness. Yeah, and nothing shall escape them. Nothing. That's the thermonuclear missiles. Okay? Now, say if you're walking, you know, picture the Garden of Eden, you're walking, you know, you got lush, you know, ground, you know, vegetation, you know, beautiful places, right? You walk in, you're beautiful. You turn around, it's desolate, burnt up, scorched, nothing there but death, destruction, darkness, gloominess. The day of the heavenly father Yahweh, by Hashem Yahweh, the day of the Lord. That's how that's going to be. That's how that is going to be. Okay? A fire devoured before them, behind them a flame burning. The land is as the garden of Eden before them. Okay? And behind them a desolate wilderness. Yeah, and nothing shall escape them. There's no escape. Nothing will escape. Okay? The appearance of them is as the appearance of horses and horsemen. So shall they run. Okay? That's those thermonuclear missiles. Okay? That is those thermonuclear missiles. Isaiah 9 and 5. And it reads, for every battle, the warriors with confused noise, and garments rolled in blood, but this shall be the burning of fuel and fire. Hey, back in the ancient days, they had the shields, the bucklers, okay? The shields were bigger. The bucklers was on the arm for easy protection and use of your staffs or whatnot, okay? And you go back to World War I, World War II. You go back even to the Vietnam conflict. You know, blood, clothes, garments rolled in blood. You know, you got the war cry. They coming at you. Ah, okay, a lot of blood. You breaking necks. You know, you're stabbing, slashing, and dashing. You know, and all kind of things. All right, battle cries. You know, for every battle, the warriors with confused noise and garments rolled in blood. But this shall be the burning of fuel and fire. Back then, okay. Yeah, you had napalm and all this, but this war is going to be totally different. It's going to be with thermonuclear missiles, okay? You're going to have some missiles, but not thermonuclear, but this, the destruction and desolation, it's going to be done by thermonuclear missiles, okay? Supersonic missiles. This place is going to be destroyed in 1 hour, okay? This whole place, America, Babylon the Great, a.k.a. spiritual Sodom and Egypt, was going to be destroyed by thermonuclear missiles. It's going to be desolate. Okay. They didn't build all of these nuclear weapons to be housed in a museum. They're going to use those because the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, B'Shem, Yah HaMashiach, put it in their mind to create these things for their own destruction. Okay. For their own destruction. Isaiah 34. Isaiah 34, and let's start the first verse. Come near ye nations to hear, and hearken ye people, let the earth hear, and all that is therein, the world, and all things that come forth of it. For the indignation, that's righteous anger, of the Heavenly Father Yahweh is upon all nations, and his fury upon all their armies. He hath utterly destroyed them, he hath delivered them to the slaughter. Okay, their slain also shall be cast out, their stinks shall come up out of the carcasses. And the mountains shall be melted with their blood. Okay, well, how is them be melted? Thermonuclear missiles, okay? And all the hosts of heaven shall be dissolved, and the heavens shall be rolled together as a scroll, okay? And all their hosts shall fall down as the leaf falleth from off the vine, okay? And as the falling fig from the fig tree. That's a thermonuclear missile, okay? You know that mushroom cloud, okay? It's plenty of pictures, okay? Matter of fact, that's that scroll. Let me bring that up. No, so like it. Let me bring that up. Bring up that picture of a mushroom cloud. Okay? So like it. I got to show you. Show me the image of a mushroom cloud of a nuclear missile, a nuclear bomb. Give me the image.
Check out these pictures.
Okay? Mushroom cloud. Okay? This is what it's going to... Take a good one. This is what it's going to look like. Okay? Look at that. Okay? This is that... mushroom cloud, okay? That's that scroll, okay? Look at it. That's that scroll. That's what that's talking about, okay? Their slain shall be cast out, their stink shall come up out of the carcasses, and the mountains shall be melted with their blood, and all the hosts of heaven shall be dissolved. The heavens shall be rolled together as a scroll, okay? As a scroll. See, as a scroll. A scroll is a long roll of paper or similar material with writing on it. Imagine unrolling a scroll. That's what this is about. Okay? That's what this is about. The image I showed you, that's what they're talking about. Because that's the only way they can describe it at the time. Okay? For every battle of the warriors with confused noise and garments rolled in blood, but this shall be with burning and fuel of fire. Okay, Isaiah again, 34. For my sword shall be bathed in heaven. Behold, it shall come down upon Idumea and upon the people of my curse to judgment. Okay, Idumea, that's Edom. Okay, Esau, Edom, originally the begging family, so-called white man, okay? and upon all the people of my judgment, my curse to judgment. Okay, now the heathen nations, also the two-thirds got to go too. Okay, the sword of the Heavenly Father Yahweh is filled with blood, is made fat with fatness, and with the blood of lambs and goats, and the fat of the kidneys of rams. For the Heavenly Father Yahweh has a sacrifice in Basra, in a great slaughter in the land of Idumea. Now Basra was the chief city in Idumea. Okay, now Basra today represents America. It's America, Babylon the Great, is the chief city, okay, and which all the other nations got rich off of, okay? So, this place about to be destroyed, all right? It is about to be destroyed. Let's jump down to 13th verse. Okay, go 11 verse, start to 11. But the cormorant and the bittern shall possess it. The owl also and the raven, okay, shall dwell in it. And he shall stretch out upon it the line of confusion and the stones of emptiness. Okay, now let's look into the interlinear, all right? Let's look at that word, bittern, okay?
Strong's H, 7090. Kippod. Kippod.
Get up in the Hebrew. Root word.
Strong's H, 7088. Kafed. Kafed.
Okay, now I got to go back because I missed something. Okay. But the comrade and the bittern shall possess it. Okay. The owl also and the raven. Okay, now, when we look at that, that's talking about these creatures are going to be inhabiting the land at that time after the thermonuclear missiles hit and destroy this place, okay? Porcupine, hedge caught, shrinking animal, okay? Desert creatures, animals. But the cormorant and the bittern, okay? Let's look at that word cormorant.
Strong's H, 6893. Ka'ath.
Kaf. Okay, so perhaps a pelican or a cormorant, pelican, extinct bird, exact meaning unknown. They're talking about like different birds that's going to be inhabiting. It's not going to be any people. It's, you know, it's going to be desert birds, things that are of that nature. Okay. Now let's look at the line of confusion. Let's look at that right quick.
Strong's H, 8414. Tohu. Tohu.
Formless, confusion, unreality, emptiness, formless. Okay? Nothingness. It's going to be nothingness. When this place, Babylon the Great, a.k.a. America, spiritual Solomon, Egypt, will be destroyed by those thermonuclear missiles, it's not going to be nothing. It's going to be desolate, okay? Formless. Nothingness, empty space, and that line of confusion, wasteland, wilderness, solitary places, place of chaos, vanity, okay? And that line of confusion is dealing with, you know how you could be traveling, right? And you see those signs, it's going to say 25 miles to Denver or 100 miles to this state. You're not going to see none of that. You're not going to be able to distinguish what state was where and this, that, and the third, you won't be able to distinguish that because it's going to be a line of confusion. That's what that means. You're not going to be able to determine, well, what state is this? What state is that? Because it's going to be one desolate land. You know, and there's going to be no markers, no nothing. Okay? That's that. You know? That's how that's going to be laid out. Nothing. It's going to be, remember, of where this was and where that was. It ain't going to be no landmarks. It's not going to be anything, okay? It's not going to be anything left, okay? Line of confusion, Isaiah 54, okay? And those thermonuclear missiles hit, that's it for this place, okay? Isaiah 54 and 16. Behold, I have created the smith that bloweth the coals in the fire, and they that bring forth an instrument of his work. I have created the waster to destroy. Okay? Now, waster, it's those thermonuclear missiles, okay? And the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, by some of your homicide, put it in the mind of Esau, Edom, you know, through the scientists to create these things, okay? And these things he created for destruction is going to destroy him. Okay, again, they didn't set these things just to be in a museum, these missiles, these thermonuclear missiles. They didn't set them. They didn't create them so they can be in the museums. You see, when Russia has its parades, they're parading those missiles down. And they're not parading them for nothing. Okay, now all these other nations got the same thing that Babylon the Great, a.k.a. America, has. Okay, now I think Russia surpassed America with its thermonuclear missiles. But this place is getting ready to be destroyed. But first and foremost, what's got to come to pass is Revelation 13:16, and that's what we're warning you about, not to take it. If you take it, you're going to be destroyed. And then everything else is going to move real fast, okay? So we have hope for salvation, the elect of Israel, the ones that's out here that's diligently doing the work, out there in the highways and byways, continuously out there, hastening the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai. How are we hastening him? By calling out to him, looking for our salvation, doing the work, okay? Bringing this place down by prophesying the downfall of the rich and elite banking family, the rulers of this wicked kingdom, okay? By crying out to the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, by Hashem, Yahweh, Shai, of the injustice and the wickedness of this place, okay? That's why we do this. Okay, because this place is going down. It needs to go down. We're tired of this place. We're seeking salvation. We're calling out the name of our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shah. We're seeking for our hope of salvation. That's what we are. That's why we are obsessed with doing this, okay? Because this destruction is coming. But I can tell you this, do not take the Karama, Revelation 13:16. If you take it, you will be judged by the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shah. Read Revelation 13:16, also read Revelation 14. Chapter 14, 9 verse on down, because if you take it, that's what's going to happen to you. But we all have to endure it to the end. You know, those are the hopefully elect. And keep doing this work, okay? Make our calling and lesson sure. Because these things will happen. It's not going to tarry, okay? As Elder Apostle Tahar coined, he termed the year 2023 the year the hopeful prophecies coming to pass. And as you see, they're rolling. Okay? They're rolling. Revelation 11:14. Then I'm going to end it on this. Revelation 11, and we're going to go to the 14th verse. Starts the 13. In the same hour, there was a great earthquake, and a tenth part of the city fell. That's those 10 FEMA zones, okay? And an earthquake was slain of men 7,000. That 7,000 simply means a complete number. And the remnant was affrighted and gave glory to the power of heaven. That's our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai. Revelation 11:14. The second war is past, and behold, the third war coming quickly. Yeah, World War I, World War II. Hey, but this is the third war, and it's coming quickly, as you can see. Okay? As you can see, Habakkuk 2:3. Let me end it. and it reads, for the vision is yet for an appointed time. Okay? It's for an appointed time, but it's coming. All we have to do is stay patient. Okay? And all this, this things we are going through is just a light affliction. You got to consider the reward. We just have to endure to the end. For the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak. And not lie, do a tarry, wait for it. Because it will surely come, it will not tarry. Okay? Matthew 24:13. But he that shall endure unto the end, the same shall be saved. Okay? And that's what we have to do, endure to the end. We are in these perilous times, as you see down here. We are in those perilous times right now. Okay? A time is coming, and it's not going to tarry. So endure to the end. Okay? Endure to the end. With that, the water to Jehovah by Shem Yahweh Shai. Allow me to bring this out. All praise, honor, and glory to Jehovah by Shem Yahweh Shai. By Shem Yahweh Shai. The wonders and the apostles and others of great men who rule well. And with that, Shalom.